Let's get out of Hi, my name is Jeromie Shines, and this is another episode of Community Conversation with Ron Harrison.
Jeremy, thank you for having me here today. You know, we've been friends for a couple years now, right?
2 years.
Right.
Yeah.
2 years. You know, I come back to Battle Mountain every month, and it's a highlight of my month. You know, coming back here for 7 to 10 days, visiting with former students. We'll talk about that a little bit. But I remember the day that I met you and Nikki. I was at church, Assembly of God. That's my chosen church when I'm here in town. And you guys came in, so we hit it off. Went out to lunch that afternoon, and we've been friends ever since.
It's been a journey. Right. I'm sure you've seen me grow, because I barely came to the faith at that time when I got here too. And you always said that. No, you would always look at me in a certain way. So he kind of said it in his face, and my wife was saying, Why don't they call it butt cheeks? Why don't they call it face cheeks? Anyways.
Well, maybe I saw in you something more than you saw in yourself 2 years ago.
And that's what we're here to talk about. Entrepreneurship. Wow. Here we are. We just started our page, Battle Mountain Media and Television. And you've always been there along that walk with me, even though I didn't know I was walking in.
Right.
So tell us about that.
Well, it's pretty amazing. You know, when we talk about entrepreneurship, entrepreneurs like Henry Ford, Steve Jobs, Thomas Edison, they found a niche. They found a need that nobody was filling. And that's one of the keys for entrepreneurship, is find something that nobody else is doing or that somebody else maybe is not doing as well as can be done, and then do something better. So that's what you're doing with this. You know, Battle Mountain doesn't have a TV station. We have the Battle Mountain Bugle. I love the Bugle. You'll get a little bit of news, local news in that. But I just picture this as being an opportunity for you to help promote local businesses, local organizations, community activities, promote the town of Battle Mountain on multimedia, on social media, and things like that. Because, you know, there are only 300 million Americans, right? Mm-hmm. Nearly all of them have access to what you're putting out there.
Yeah.
That's gonna be just huge. So I'm really excited to help you with different ideas on that.
Yeah. And before I got started, I went to film school for a year or two, you know, actually maybe like a while.
Yeah.
And I dabbled in a lot of other things, and I've worked in a lot of different places, and I never knew that entrepreneurship was where I was headed towards. And it was strange, because now I use what I've learned from those different places into the business, and I'm like, oh, I know about that. Oh yeah, I know how to do that. And it's coming together, bless you. Yeah. And yeah, you were always there just hovering over me. When are you gonna make this something more?
Go ahead, you can do that, you can cut that. Go ahead, do
that again. I'm not cutting that out.
Well, you know, and I taught high school for 20 years, so I got to Battle Mountain in 1989. I was familiar with Lander County, and I got my first teaching job here. Fred Huckabee hired me. So I taught for 4 years, and I've always liked helping people. Mm-hmm. That's what a teacher is, right? It's a helping heart, a servant attitude. Mm-hmm. So I did that for 20 years, and now I'm doing it in my financial business, but I'm also coming across people like you who inspire me, because I remember when I had entrepreneurial ideas in my early 20s and 30s, and my wife Kim, you know, Battle Mountain native, Kim Walters, and you know, we've done a bunch of different business things, and now it's my way of giving back to people. I have a couple of people I work in Grand Junction where we live, and we're mentoring them into doing what is in their heart, doing their businesses. So that's why I love being able to help you. And the other thing about this entrepreneurial stuff, and you asked me earlier about how Battle Mountain has changed over the years. so many more opportunities in Battle Mountain. And we see people that they want to be entrepreneurs, so they're doing some of the network marketing companies and things like that. There's some fantastic companies out there, some awesome products, and people are helping lots of people. But with this community, just like you're doing, you're finding a need, and there are other needs around Battle Mountain. And people always say, well, we need to get so-and-so to come in and have this restaurant come in and that restaurant come in. Don't have that restaurant come in. You become the restaurant. You do something unusual, like a food truck. I mean, if your passion is food. So, you know, don't think that somebody else has to do the work for you. Create what you need.
And that's, yeah, and that's it. It was just the idea of, you know, I always had my, you know, daydreaming of me in Hollywood. And what I've actually learned is a lot of people who are in Hollywood started doing things that I was doing. And you got to lower your expectations, you know. And one of the greatest quotes is, be the change you want to see in the world. And it was just like when, you know, being inspired, and like the world is not going to change until we change. And I say that in every video so far. It's just because it's true, you know. I was at a dead-end job. This is it. This is what I'm going to do for 20 years. Wasn't inspired by it.
Right.
Could care less about, you know, it growing. But now I'm in a place where I'm like, this is what I'm passionate about. Every morning, I wouldn't really want to get up or work the 12-hour days. Now I'm working longer and with passion through every step of the way. It's like, wow, this is what I want to do. And this is what I want to do for the rest of my life. Jim Carrey said, I watched my dad work at a dead-end job. They laid him off for 4 years. He devoted himself to.
Right.
If you could fail at something that you don't like, you might as well try to fail at something that you love.
Correct. So. Yeah, that's the other part of being an entrepreneur and, you know, charting your own path, if you want to say it that way, is just realizing you might have to start at the beginning. Mm-hmm. Where did Mark Zuckerberg start Facebook? In his college dorm, right?
Right.
Little tiny 10 by 12 room. And now he's a billionaire. Where did Bill Gates? Bill Gates started in the garage with a buddy of some piece of, you know, yard sale computer or something.
Right. By the way, we had toilet paper up here. So we removed that toilet paper for appropriate reasons. I don't go to the bathroom back here. I used to blow my nose.
Okay.
I just wanted to let you know that.
But so I think the point Jeremy's trying to make is that you could, you know, start off small, and then you could, your future is going to blossom with you. It's going to grow. And actually, that's happening with the business that Kim and I do, the financial stuff that we do. We started from our home in Grand Junction. Still come out here every month, do business.
Mm-hmm.
Then we now have about 3,000 square feet of office space. In Grand Junction, we have an event center that's 900 square feet. We have weekly events in there when people come in. And we're doing work in Elko. We're expanding this fall into Boise. So you start little, and as success comes,
you started in a what?
We started in our house, I mean, on our kitchen table.
And now
and there's just blossoming. That's what happens. And the reason that's happening for us and other people that do these types of things, whether that's network marketing or like you're doing, is because the passion is there and it's in your heart. It's what you know that you're born to do.
Mm-hmm.
Once you have that, then the sky's the limit.
Mm-hmm. And that's right? The thing. It's just like your passion has to be so powerful when you get the haters, when you get the no's, your passion still perseveres through that. Your faith in seeing what other people can't see. You reach into the spiritual and you pull it into the physical. And it's like you're bringing something new, that you're fulfilling a need. Battle Mountain doesn't have a media thing. And as I was looking at names, I was like, what's a name I want? I'm trying to be witty, you know? And I'm just like, Battle Mountain Media and Television. No one's using that, you know, like, why. There's a battle on classifieds, true classifieds, true classifieds, classifieds, true classifieds. You know, it's just like... Battle Mountain Media and Television. No one's used it.
That was great.
Yeah.
And that's going to let you do so many different things, too. You know, not only these, but right. I could see you shooting commercials for companies mm-hmm. around Battle Mountain. Going to whether you know, church organizations or community groups and doing promotional videos for them. Mm-hmm. Going to the schools mm-hmm. and doing events for them and putting all this stuff out for social media. One of the great things I see you're really going to help the community is with the next year, next August, is the 2020 all-class reunion. Mm-hmm. That's going to be a great opportunity for you. And people, I'm sure people are going to start getting a hold of you now mm-hmm. and to get your time because you need to get those things scheduled. But you're going to provide such a service mm-hmm. to this community. Mm-hmm. And I guarantee that we're going to start seeing people say, you know, I learned about Battle Mountain. I was online. I saw these community videos. Mm-hmm. I just thought, I need to go find out about that place.
And I did that when I came here, and I didn't see nothing except a video of some person with a phone camera recording their family at a restaurant. And I was like,
right.
Where's the networking here? Other than Battle Mountain Classifieds, there's no, there's just in the word of mouth. There's no radio station here. If there is, it's, or a police scanner, I heard. But then, you know, there are no filmmakers here because all the filmmakers are in Hollywood or in big cities.
Well, they have different ideas. I mean, their ideas are to become rich from doing filmmaking.
Right.
Your idea is to serve people through your films, through the commercials you do and things like that. That's the big difference.
And that I had to let go of that, too. Not that I still don't want to make films. It was just that, you know, God put us here in Battle Mountain, and I've been crying and moaning to God, just being like, why are we here?
Right.
There's nothing here, you know? And he's just like, you're here.
There you
what
go.
About it? Right. I'm here. I got a little camera. People see the camera. They're like, oh my God, just a bad camera. Could be a movie star, you know? Could be on TV. And I'm just in here just like, you're going to be edited out of this video. No, but just like, the point is like, I have a camera. I started off filming with a phone.
Yeah.
That's where my roots come from, you know. And I run across a lot of people who just make excuse after excuse after excuse. I don't have this. I need this, and then I would do it. Mm-hmm. If you're not being willing to just go out there and do it now, you're never going to do it.
Yeah, you know, people think about when this happens, then I will take the next step. Or I'll make that decision, or I'll get that business license, mm-hmm. or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
When people are in that frame of mind, mm-hmm. they will never, ever get to where they want to be.
Mm-hmm.
What you have to do is just take that step by step by step
mm-hmm.
and stop letting those excuses get in your way.
Mm-hmm. You got to just literally throw those doubts out, because I met a guy who had a whole studio, his room, went to his house, cameras, lighting, everything, boom, 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 boom. I'm like, he's like, yo. And I'm like, can I see your work? I don't have anything. You don't have anything? Like, what are you talking about, man? Like, you're tripping, you know?
Right.
My friend, one of my friends, he just been like, kind of the same way. He had equipment and stuff. I don't have this on. I'm just sitting there just literally like, you know, like I'd be take my phone, set it on a tripod, and then I'd just shoot a little short film. And it's just like, you have all you need. What you have is what you need.
If you wait for things, other people, time to be perfect, you will never, ever take the leap.
Mm-hmm.
And so many people want to do that. It's sort of like if somebody was writing a book,
mm-hmm.
and they have great ideas and everything, they're sitting there, well, you know, I have an idea for chapter one, chapter two, chapter three, but I don't have an idea for the last chapter. Well, 2 months later, still don't have an idea for the last chapter. They haven't even started writing the book. That idea for the last chapter will come
right.
as they start writing the book.
As you and walk by faith, not by sight. And it's just the idea of what, you know, not the church background, but just my faith. It's just like the Bible says, God says, as you walk towards your goal, like Abraham walked in the middle of the desert and said, I'm going to make you a father of nations. Go to the middle of the desert.
Right.
And he just like... By his believing God, he walked out, and God started to provide, and suddenly, here we are. And it's just like, as I'm like, oh, I want to be a pastor, but I'll be a pastor if God provides. As you walk, he will provide. As you're walking it out, he will provide. And it's like, that's what's happening with us. It's like, as you walk, he's providing. And it's like, it's a miracle. I'll tell you one experience I had. In Montana, me and my wife, we just barely met and stuff like that. We were getting comfortable with each other. We were shooting music videos. And I had my camera, and I was like, I've just finished the song, and I was like, I want to shoot a music video. We're just going to go out and shoot. Literally, this is what happened. As we went out, there were these kids just hanging around the train tracks, and I was like, hey, you want to be in a music video? They're in our music video. How did that happen? How did it come together? They shared that music video, and it's like 300 views or something like that. And I'm like, whoa. It just happens.
Right. Yeah, you take that step. You know, I kind of liken it sometimes. If, let's say it's real foggy. You know, I know we get fog here in the Battle Mountain every once in a while, right? So you have to drive to Winnemucca. So you're on the road. Your lights only shine so far. Well, would you turn around and stay home because your lights aren't shining all the way to Winnemucca and shining your whole path, right? You wouldn't do that, would you? You'd get on that road because your lights are shining just far enough for you to see to keep driving, right? Well, that's the same with steps in entrepreneurship.
Yeah.
Take that step, and then the next step will reveal itself.
Right.
And don't have to see the whole path.
It's shining. He's just shining all the way to that. Right? And that's unfortunate, is because that's the generation we live in. It's, knowledge is great. The second most powerful thing besides God. But there was no God. But there is a God. So, and it's just like, we need so much information where it's just like, just do it. Nike, that's yeah. Gold right there. Just do it.
Yeah, just, you know, whatever knowledge you have, that's the beginning. But then, as you said, I mean, knowledge is the second most important thing, and it is. It can never be taken away from you. One of the unfortunate things, though, about our system and the way most of us are raised, we finish high school, 12 years of school, we finish college, so 16 years total. So many people, millions of people, never pick up another book. They never read a book from cover to cover. That's unfortunate, because every piece of knowledge we can bring in is going to make us a better person. Right?
Yeah, it's going to make you not only better in your business, if you have a business or not, just a better person. And, you know, as far as business is concerned, and people do see you in town, and they may not know what you do. You know, because they're not informed, and hopefully we want to give you that, not only you, but everyone there. Even if somebody doesn't do, hopefully they're doing something, but
right.
Even if they're just, like, they just want to be seen, we want to show people that, hey, people are just like you and me, trying to make their way, trying to, you know, live life hopefully better, and we want to talk about a little bit about what you do.
Sure, well, you know, I shared a little bit earlier. I came here as a teacher, taught 4 years, moved off to Colorado, teaching there. So I'm a licensed teacher and administrator for about 20 years. Mm-hmm. Then 7 years ago, I found out about a financial company. Kim and I needed some financial advice. Here I was, a business teacher, and I taught financial things, but I knew that I needed to talk to an expert. Mm-hmm. So I talked with him, he got us lined out, and Kim said to me, so which one of us is going to go to work for this company? So I did, and it started part-time, moved into full-time. Now it's both of us doing this, mm-hmm. full-time, 4 feet in the pool, mm-hmm. working all over the Western United States. But,
wow.
You know, it's all about education. We talked earlier about knowledge, right? There are two things really important in life. There's knowledge, because with knowledge you have choices. Mm-hmm. The other thing most important in life to have choices is money. Mm-hmm. Money gives you choices. A lot of people say money is evil. It's not. Mm-hmm. Money lets you decide where you live, how your kids live, the type of food you eat, the cars you drive, what your future is going to be like. So there's no inherent evil in money, but there are evil people that use money for evil, right?
A knife or a hammer.
Yeah, they're
how you use it.
There you go.
You can use it.
Great analogy. Great analogy.
We explained that in another video. And if you don't know what that is, or you don't know where I'm going, you need to read a book.
Exactly. Right. But So, you know, Kim and I just decided that we're going to educate people about options they have with their money. So we sit down with people. If somebody says, you know, I'm going to retire in 5 years, I really want to get things lined out, see what, and we sit down with them and talk about that. Mm-hmm. If I meet a young person that just started a job at one of the mines, and if they know that they want to have an awesome, positive financial future and probably retire early, mm-hmm. I'll sit down with them and say, here's an option. Here's how you can do it if you choose to. It doesn't matter to me whether you do it. Mm-hmm. I'm just a teacher, just like when I was in the classroom.
But I want to bring that up because that was a great point in our last video.
You mean our practice video?
our practice again.
Practice makes perfect.
But landmines.
Right.
Right? You're walking down a path and someone comes up to you and says, hey, there's a tack or a mine there. Don't step on that. And then you walk down that path, you step on that, and you go, why didn't you tell me about that tack? I stepped on it, hurt my foot. You know, and it's just like, I tried to tell you, but you don't like to be corrected.
Well, yeah, and some people, they need to learn from their own experience. Mm-hmm. So, you know, like a child, you know, if they touch a burner on a stove, well, we could tell them, don't touch that burner. It's hot. But when they touch it, so Jay, we were talking earlier about minefield. So my question to you, if there's a minefield in front of us and I walk through it safely, now I holler back, hey, Jeremy, you need to come through that minefield. What are you going to do to get through that minefield?
Well, I'd hope I'd follow your path.
You'd step in the right where my feet step, right?
Yeah.
That's mentoring, but it's also being a good mentee, if you want to call it that. But the idea is learn from people that came before you so you don't repeat there. You don't blow yourself up, right?
Right. And that's what all these books are for, because there's a lot of traps in life, you know, wherever. And that's why people write books, right?
Sure. Yeah, learn from other people's experiences. So many people say, you know what, I'm going to be my own boss. Nobody else is going to tell me how to do this. Well, those people might end up getting to the successful part. They may end up on the trip along the way and get to the end. But they are going to definitely blow themselves up along the way and have to start over. Isn't it so much easier to not have the start over happen?
Right, and that's the thing is, I feel like what you're saying is, the moment you stop learning is the moment you not only die spiritually, but whatever you're doing fails. Now, failure is to come, but it's all about getting back up and learning from your mistakes. You know, I've had to talk to so many people. Why did your marriage fail? When I was at my last job, there were a lot of people I could talk to. And they would say, oh, it's because of them. And I hear the same thing over and over again.
Right.
And it's just like, well, why does this person's marriage succeed? And I hear the same thing over and over and over again. And it's just like, why does this in life keep happening to you over and over and over and over again? You're not learning from your mistakes. You know what I mean?
Right. Yeah, you know, there's a saying that if you want something to change in your life, you have to change something in your life, right? And you know, so many people just keep doing the same thing. That's the definition of stupidity or ignorance. Doing the same thing, expecting different results, right?
And that's where I had to change my business over and over and over again. And that's, you still have to do that.
All the time. I mean, you know, you can have the greatest business in the world, but if you're not cognizant of what else is happening in the world, making changes along the way, you're not going to maintain all that success.
Yeah, sure. And that's what it's about. It's about staying high.
Joy.
Right at the very end, every single time. See, that's probably
love
why.
Joy.
That's why we had to record 4 times in a row.
Because this is meant to be. Joy is awesome. Joy is a cute $1 million baby. It's beautiful.
Go ahead and a little of that, and let's finish on that too.
On what?
$1 million baby.
Yeah, one of the things we do is $1 million baby. So it takes somebody like Joy, who's 2 years old, and parents, grandparents, aunts, uncles, whomever, they can set those $1 million baby savings plans up, which is just fantastic. So when Joy gets to be 18, ready for college, or 25, out of college, a giant pile of money for her that just keeps grows and grows and compounds. That's just something to talk to people about. And for somebody like Joy, it's like $30 to $40 a month to get that going. Just an incredible legacy for parents and grandparents to leave.
That's what the future is. we work hard in this life, not for ourselves. We're working before the day that we leave for these.
That's right. Exactly right.
And that's you gotta leave behind something greater. And what is that saying? Leave it better than you found it.
Just, I mean, you go camping. Leave it better than you found it. You borrow somebody's car. Leave it better than you found it.
Right.
The world.
Leave it better than you found it. I can't turn back the dial on the speedometer. Sorry.
Okay. Drive back.
All right.
Now, Jeromie, it's just awesome that you're doing this. The community's going to benefit so much. And I encourage people to get a hold of Jeromie, because he just has some fantastic ideas to promote businesses and organizations.
I appreciate that so much. Because if it wasn't for Ron, you guys wouldn't be watching this. So you better be a little grateful. You better be grateful. Thank you for tuning in.
Awesome, Jeromie.
Thank you so much.
I appreciate it.
All right. God bless.